What's up, everybody? We're Side After Dark, your new favorite band. I'm Dan Berg.
I'm Sifa Graffiti.
Check out our music. And check out us reacting to Slaves and Bulldozers by the legendary Soundgarden. This was selected by our patron, Gary Simonson. Shout out to you, Gary. We appreciate you. If y'all don't know, all of our reactions are chosen by our patrons on Patreon. So go over there, check it out, get involved in our content decisions, and thumbs up if you like this video.
We'll be right back.
For the win once again.
I mean, the whole band showed out on that one, bro. I feel like.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that's a, like, if I wanted to introduce somebody to Soundgarden, I feel like that would be a good song.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Because it had all the elements. Like, it started out just with the that bass that was super low. I'm like, oh, yeah. Like, it's funny. Like, I heard that bass, and I was like, oh, like, just from this, like, I understand why people called this grunge.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I was like, oh, this is just, like, dirty. You know what I mean?
I would call this music airy. Airy.
What's the opposite of grunge?
I don't know. I tried to find one, and the first one that popped in was airy. I don't know.
Airy?
Grungy
versus airy?
Frilly. I don't know.
Frilly? Yeah, Soundgarden. Such a frilly little band. But yeah, and then the drums were grooving too, and then of course, you know, Chris. Chris does what he does.
I mean, vocally, it's just, I mean, that was awesome. That was everything. Like, I don't know what else to say. I mean, the voice went from one register. It went low and low. And then he started screaming and growling at us like he usually does.
The thing that's crazy about him is, like, he hits those high notes, but he hits them with, like, the same amount of power that he hits with the lower notes.
Yeah.
That's, you know what I mean? Because most of the time when you get higher, you can't hit it as hard because that's because how it works. I don't know. But I feel like he can just do that no matter where the note is. It still has the same power behind it.
That's how I feel too. Like, I just feel like, and then and he was so young when this song came out, like when he recorded this, and his voice sounds like he's like, I don't know, he's just been to the depths. Like, it just sounds so mature to me, you know?
That's true. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he definitely sounds like he's been around.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And this is basically somebody who's like fresh out of his teens, basically. You know what I mean? He's fairly young here.
Right. Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't know, like, the timeline of this album and stuff. Well, he was probably, like, 22, 23, something like that.
Yeah. You know what I mean? And it's just, like, yeah. You know, he's not in his mid-20s. He's not approaching 30. He's, like, 22. Like, it's college. And, you know, even I, like, my first year in college, like, I think about senior year, junior year in high school. I'm like, that was so long ago. Okay. like, you know, but like when you think about it, it's like it's not, especially now that you're like over the 25, 26 mark, you know, when you think about senior year high school and stuff like that compared to like first, second year of college, it's not that long a time. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, he's like fresh. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's just, he just passed around the team bend, you know?
Some people just have it, you know, Chris had it for sure.
Yeah.
And the whole band had it. And shout out to the guitar solo as well.
Yeah, that was crazy. That really matched his cat-like growl. Like, it was like, wow. Like, wow. Like, that was just insane. Like,
it was like, what?
Wow.
Wow, wow, we were. Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, it was perfect.
Yeah, absolutely.
Shout out to Soundgarden. They always kill it. I mean, we knew that before we were doing reactions, but obviously we've heard more Soundgarden doing this, so they never disappoint. So shout out to that. And shout out to Gary for suggesting it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And of course, shout out to the Patriots. Oh, sorry.
What were you saying? We need to find the opposite for garden. Is it like grave? No sound grave. They're definitely not that.
The opposite of grunge. I don't know. Like,
the opposite of garden now, too. Like, what's the opposite? Because it's a sound garden. You know, everything's fresh and, like, out there for you to pick and listen to. What's the opposite? Is it like a
sound graveyard?
Exactly. Toneless grave or something. Deaf? Definitely.
Yeah, yeah. I was going to say deaf graveyard.
Oh,
but toneless grave is just, I feel like toneless grave sounds better. That's definitely a metal band name, toneless grave. You know what I mean? And the singer's tone deaf.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, if we
have to be a fan to be into it, because it's not, you know.
I think so.
Yeah. Do you have any other comments on the song?
No. I was going to make a joke. Like, if we come out with a sad record label, Toneless Grave is the band that we're going to sign. We're going to name them that.
Or that's the Toneless Grave Recordings.
Yes, that's a good one.
Yeah. Be on the lookout for that in the year 2068. Why not? So thanks for being here, everyone. Shout out to Gary for suggesting this. Shout out to all the patrons for making this possible. Shout out to everybody watching on YouTube. We're S.A.D. After Dark, and we'll see you soon.